Yeah, we've repositioned slightly. Luckily, everyone can see now, and the leopards are lying down. You can see the female. Her belly looks quite full. Do you see that? A full belly, so I wonder if she didn't have a kill. Perhaps he was trying to look, this young male was trying to look for some scraps. So I'm sure all of you have had a good look at these leopards, and I think you can confirm it is Thandi and Hosana. Very interesting to see this young male hang around this female. Is such a wonderful sighting, and luckily for us they did decide to come out into the open. So they are lying down in some long grass, but we can still see them very clearly compared to where they were, and there's still a little bit of golden light on them. Riti, no, leopards won't change the shade of the coat depending on the season. Their coats may become a little bit thicker in the winter, but it definitely doesn't change shade or color, not at all. Now, genetically, the genetics of leopards varies slightly. So just like our skin colors, some skin is darker than others. Same with leopards, same with giraffe. We speak about it regularly. And I remember there used to be a beautiful leopard down in the south of Ndolozi, known as the Sunset Bend female. Some of you may have heard of her. Very well-known leopard. And she had a beautiful golden coat, Sunset Bend. Lovely, lovely golden coat. And her lineage, her offspring in that also, generally had slightly more yellow coats or golden coat compared to some of the other leopards down there. And the same with any leopard, really. Some are slightly darker, slightly more golden, and others are a bit lighter. Must be honest, this is one of my favorite things to do. Well, I mean, after this morning, we had quite a quiet morning, but to be able to now sit and spend time with these leopards is very special, and we are very, very lucky. Ali, I'm not sure. You asked where do I think Tamba is. I don't know. I don't know. Now, again, trying to think. I still haven't. I mean, some of you are very good at identifying these leopards. I'm not that good. I haven't seen them enough to know the exact, you know, little signs and spot patterns. I mean, this does look like Hosana. If I can just get confirmation from you that it definitely is Hosana and not Tamba. I don't think it's Tamba. It looks a bit bigger. And then, Ali, I'll answer your question. It's hard to say because if you know, sometimes what happens is, of course, Ali, you know that the female will leave her young cub in an area, go off and hunt, and then potentially go back and fetch him. So she may have left Tamba somewhere, moved off and gone trying to hunt and bumped into Hosana, or Hosana bumped into her, and is now trying to latch onto her, maybe see if she's got a kill and that she might take him too, perhaps. Maybe that's what's happened here. But I just want to make sure, like I say, unfortunately can't, I mean, I don't know these leopards. I haven't seen these leopards enough to 100% ID them. And I don't want to make a mistake. Now, I know a lot of you can get screenshots and it's a bit easier to look at the spot pattern. And I've been moving around quite a lot. So just, if you can confirm that it is definitely Hosana and definitely Thandi, it'll make it a bit easier for me to tell you what I think has happened here and what is going on. But I think that's possibly what has happened. Tandy's moved off, gone to potentially try and hunt left Tamba in an area and then bumped into Hosana. Who would have thought we'd have two leopard this afternoon? Now this is a wonderful peaceful sighting, and you know what, in situations like this, and I've mentioned it before with elephant too, in certain sightings we've had, it's sometimes nice just to sit and appreciate and view them. They're resting. You, in sightings like this, I find you don't have to say too much, depending on obviously if guests are asking you questions and that, but it's nice just to appreciate the sounds around you. There's a lot of birds calling, Cape turtle doves, starlings. There was a little scops owl calling earlier too in the drainage line not far from us. And I think to appreciate the peace and quiet and tranquility of the sighting is really wonderful. Tony, you say safety in numbers, so that Hosana can potentially get a better sleep with the female leopard close to him. Oh, perhaps, although she was looking quite aggressive towards him earlier. So as long as he doesn't get too close, he should be okay. Sorry. Painted Wolfie asked if Karula was still around, would she have chased Thandi away? Most definitely. The reason for that, we know the leopards are very territorial, and Karula would not have tolerated, I don't think she would have tolerated. Now, we know Thandi is indeed offspring of Karula. Oh, I hope I don't get that wrong, but I'm certain Tandy's offspring of Karula. She may have tolerated her, but she probably would have growled and pushed her out a little bit, because when they are territorial, even though they meet up with their offspring now and then when they do meet up with their offspring, they probably tolerate each other. There we go, her head's up now. But it's always difficult to say. Maybe she would have, I think because Tani's established her own territory, she's older and she's mated and she's had cubs of her own, I don't think Karula would have been as accommodating. Oh, look at her, she's still growling a little bit. Beautiful. Isn't that wonderful? Look at the light in her eyes. Flock of Egyptian geese flying over us. You could probably hear them very loud. look at that. I suppose if Craig zooms out quite a bit more, I mean, it's like almost like one of those competitions, spot the leopard. If you see, I mean, look where Thandi is in that long grass. It's actually quite difficult to spot her, isn't it? Look at that. You can see Hosana clearly. He's lying out in the open a little bit, but look, the further back we go, Thandi starts to disappear. You can just see a bit of movement there now and then. There we go, she's up now. Let's see where she's going. Let's see how Hosana reacts to her. Look, he's definitely interested and curious in following her. Oh, look at this, they're gonna walk right in front of us, I think. I'm just gonna keep my voice down. Now listen to him, he's contact calling. But look how close she is to us. We'll try not move too much, because we know Thandi can sometimes get a little bit upset when the vehicles get too close to her, but she's chosen to walk past us, so we're okay, we're not interfering at all. But listen to Hosana. And then you'll hear Thandi growling at him. He's giving a contact call. Very interesting behavior. Looks like they're heading back up towards the dam. Just going to move forward here a little bit. This is wonderful to see. Sorry, two leopards, it's moving around like this, and to have them so close to the, did I drive over some dung there? Can smell it. See, look how full her belly is. She's definitely fed recently. She's going to be going. This is such a fantastic sighting. Oh, Beard, you say it doesn't seem like she's trying to lose him. No, no. He seems quite persistent in following her. Sorry, I think I drove over some leopard scat. Does not smell very good at all. Here we go, they're still moving, but it's amazing to see how he's still following her and staying close to her. This leopard scat does not smell good at all. Where's she gone? Can you still see her there, Craig, on that side? She's going up. No, there she goes. Okay, I'm gonna race around quickly. No. And these leopards. I think Taurus.
Well, come back.